Welcome to Thermal Grizzly's application guide for Conductonaut and Conductonaut Extreme on graphics cards. In this video, we'll show you how to safely and correctly apply these gallium-based liquid metal compounds, along with our best practices and tips. Before we get started, an important note. Liquid metal is more demanding to use than conventional thermal paste. Please make sure you've read the safety instructions included in the box. While it's typically recommended for experienced users, anyone can apply it safely by following the proper steps and precautions you'll see in this video. Conductonaut and Conductonaut Extreme offer similar performance. Extreme has a slightly lower melting point, giving it an edge for extreme applications. When running high-end systems, every degree matters. Traditional thermal pastes fill microscopic gaps, but solid particles limit how thin the layer can be. Thermal Grizzly liquid metal flows into the tiniest imperfections. The result? Superior heat transfer, exceeding all other interface materials in portfolio. Liquid metal works best in these scenarios. D-lidded CPU with direct die cooler. D-lidded CPU with high performance heat spreader. GPU with cooler. Laptops requiring high-performance cooling. Specific consoles, such as PlayStation 5. Important: the cooler base must be nickel-plated. Never apply liquid metal to aluminum surfaces. Gallium will corrode them. Inside the package, you'll find 1 syringe with liquid metal, 1 metal needle for application, 1 plastic needle for removal, 2 industrial cotton buds, 2 alcohol pads, 1 certificate of origin, and the instruction manual. Proper cleaning is essential. Start by wiping the GPU die and cooler base with the included alcohol pads to remove any old thermal compounds. Then use a dry wipe to make sure both surfaces are completely clean and dry. Liquid metal is electrically conductive. Before applying it, protect the SMD components around your GPU die with Thermal Grizzly GPU guard or another suitable insulation material to prevent short circuits. If you're working on an RTX 5090, 5080, or 4080, use the pre-cut NVIDIA set. For other GPUs, the universal version can be trimmed to fit your layout. Peel off the backing film. Place the guard around the GPU die, tap it gently so it adheres, then remove the top protective layer. You can also use Thermal Grizzly shield coating or a Kapton insulation sheet as alternatives. Just don't combine multiple insulation materials. Layering them can cause mounting or clearance issues. Put on gloves to protect your skin. Attach the metal needle to the syringe, then place a tiny, pin-sized drop in the center of both the GPU die and the cooler. If you accidentally apply too much, use the plastic needle to remove the excess. Spread the liquid metal evenly using one of the included industrial lint-free cotton swabs. Apply pressure on the tip until it makes a soft, squishy noise. Stop once you've created a thin, uniform, silver coating. Don't forget to apply liquid metal to your GPU cooler. Once finished, carefully install your GPU cooler. Do not over-tighten the screws to prevent instability or damage. Thank you. When reapplying, first wipe the GPU die and cooler surfaces with a dry wipe to remove old residue. Then use an alcohol pad and finish with another dry wipe. Remove the GPU guard slowly and carefully. Residue can collect along the edges and may spread onto surrounding SMDs if pulled too quickly. Clean any affected areas thoroughly before applying new insulation. Finally, apply fresh insulation material, and then apply fresh liquid metal, as demonstrated in this video. Liquid metal can remain in your system for years. It won't dry out like conventional pastes, but it can migrate or pump out under heavy thermal cycling. Monitor your temperatures over time and reapply if you notice performance decreasing. Key tips to remember: never apply liquid metal to aluminum coolers, as they will corrode. Make sure the cooler base is nickel plated. Insulate surrounding SMD components to prevent short circuits, but avoid using multiple insulation materials at the same time. Apply a thin layer of liquid metal to both contact surfaces, the GPU die and the cooler base. Do not over-tighten cooler mounting screws. Recycle old or excess material responsibly. Thanks for watching. For more information, visit our website, our support resources, or follow us on social media.